This video was developed by the Tennessee Integrated Food Safety Center of Excellence. This video will cover some tips and tricks to help make using REDCap easier. By default, REDCap labels each record with the record ID only. REDCap users can add a level of validation to help ensure the correct record is being chosen by appending the facility name to the record number. This can be achieved by setting up custom record labels in Project Setup. Under Additional Customizations, checking the Set a Custom Record Label box will allow the box to become editable. Variables from the project can now be piped next to the record label using square brackets. In this project, the facility name variable is facility_name. Now, each record will be labeled with the record ID and facility name. Any project variable can be piped into the custom record label field. These labels can also be seen in the record status dashboard. Also found within the Additional Customization menu is the option to designate a secondary unique field. This feature will prevent duplicate records from being created. For example, if a project calls for unique email addresses, REDCap will check the value in a chosen text field in real time. It will return an error and will not allow the record to be saved if a value matches a previous one. Many other helpful REDCap customizations can be found when modifying survey settings. It may be helpful to choose enhanced radios and checkboxes to enlarge the look of the response buttons on the survey. The survey elements can also be customized color-wise, either with a preset theme or by choosing each color manually. Sometimes it is helpful to break the survey into multiple pages to prevent survey fatigue. To do this, choose Multiple Pages under the Pagination option. If the survey is designed to send an email to survey participants, choose which field has the email stored. The Survey Expiration option changes the survey to inactive after the date and time specified in this setting. Sometimes, it may be beneficial for survey respondents to return to their records and change or add to their answers. The option Save and Return Later allows this. If the survey collects private health information, it is recommended that a respondent be required to input a return code to access their record. This will provide an extra layer of security. The system will generate a return code and email it to the respondent. They can click the link, input the return code, and access their record. There are also a couple of different options for what happens when the survey is successfully submitted. There are options for the REDCap survey to loop and start over, which is beneficial for surveys that may need to be completed more than once or auto-continue to the next survey. Respondents can also be redirected to a website after survey completion. The default setting includes a standard thank you message, which can be customized. REDCap can also be set up to send a confirmation email, which is helpful for sending a respondent a copy of their answers or any pertinent attachments, such as a calendar invitation for an event requiring registration. The difference between the defaulted thank you message and the confirmation email is that the default message simply shows on the screen. It may be necessary to end a survey based on a respondent's answers before they answer all questions. For example, suppose the REDCap survey asks if the respondent wants to register. If they select no, there is no need to continue registration. The Stop Survey action prompts the survey to end based on specified criteria. This is set up in the Online Designer. Navigate to the question that will prompt the end of the survey and click the stop sign icon. Choose the answer that should prompt the respondent to end the survey in the Stop Survey logic box. When a respondent takes the survey and chooses the designated response to end it, REDCap will notify the respondent that they can either end the survey now or undo the last response to continue. The Stop Survey option works with drop-down lists, radio buttons, checkboxes, yes/no fields, and true/false fields. REDCap also has an option to automatically save a PDF of the survey respondent's answers in its file repository. To enable this setting, scroll to the bottom of the survey settings page, just above the confirmation email. Choose the option that says Auto Archiver Enabled, then save the changes. The file repository is found under the Applications menu on the left-hand side. This concludes the video showcasing some helpful REDCap tips and tricks.